running doesn't have to be hard on the body. And Dr. Daniel Lieberman, who's an evolutionary biologist at Harvard University, has done many landmark studies on how being barefoot may be very critical to healthy functioning mechanics, especially in running. This is why Dr. Lieberman still has a continuing influence on guiding runners through his research on biomechanics to be more mechanically competent in running in a way that's very functional and more safe. Here's more on what Dr. Daniel Lieberman had to say about the type of running mechanics that do not consistently work well for injury prevention and may actually hurt running performance on some higher level.
I think there's a number of key elements to good running form. And the first is not to overstride. Overstride is when you stick your leg out in front of you and you land with your foot in front of your knee and really way in front of your hip. A lot of people think that they're running hard when they do that. You know why? Because they are running hard. Because when you stick your leg out in front of you, you actually decelerate from the time it takes for your center of mass of your body to get over your foot. You're actually losing energy. The other thing that happens when you overstride is that when you stick your foot out in front of you, it'll make your leg stiffer. And you have this what's called an impact peak, and this shockwave travels up your body. But when you land without an overstride, you don't have that jolt of force. And you're much less likely to get injured. It's just a better way to run. Another key element to running is to run with a pretty flat foot. And I think most good runners tend to land on the ball of their foot. It just happens naturally. If you don't stick your leg far out in front of you, you will not land hard on your heel. You'll land on the ball of your foot or your midfoot strike. But it's a gentle landing. Don't lean. A lot of runners lean forward at the hips. That's another total evil. Be vertical from the hips up. If you can hear your feet, if your feet are landing really hard, if you're thumping, as we call it in my lab, that you're running poorly. That thump is the sound of the collision of your body with the ground. Running should be light and gentle and collision-free. So if you're making a lot of noise, you're running poorly. And then finally, the most important thing is if you're learning to run properly and if you haven't been doing this for a long time, listen to pain. Don't overdo it. Transition really slowly and gradually. Your body is not just designed for this instantly. If you transition to learning to run properly too fast, you are guaranteed to injure yourself. You have to adapt your body, right? You know, I think everybody can learn to run this way, or most people can learn to run this way, but you can't do it overnight.
I think most of us can strongly agree on Dr. Daniel Lieberman's assessments on the do's and don'ts of running form, but his point about running vertical or running with a upright body posture versus leaning forward was really something that I thought was very interesting. Dr. Lieberman stressed the no-no of leaning forward from the waist and instead run tall and upright. However, you can lean forward from the ankles during running, of which forward leaning from the ankles while running as a means to avoid injury, to run faster with less mechanical burdens on the lower body joints, and to sustain a faster running pace with much greater ease via forward leaning from the ankles is something that's heavily emphasized in pose running. And pose running has really done a pretty good job at referencing the raw facts for the relation of forward leaning from the ankles and giving you a bigger boost in forward momentum that sustains better health-wise on the knees and hips during running, not to mention pose running's core emphasis on forward leaning from the ankles during running does mesh with how the best runners in the world utilize their upper body posture. Here's an interesting diagram courtesy of balancedrunner.com depicting Kenenisa Bekele, who's on the far left, and Haile Gebrselassie to the right of Bekele, who are two of the arguably best distance runners in history, aside from Eliud Kipchoge, who isn't featured here. Anyways, these two runners are, for the most part, depending on their running shoe, are non-heel strike runners and are very sought after in terms of their running form. A lot of experts really like to use Bekele and Haile G as a reference point or the gold standard in learning to achieve that near perfect optimal running form that sustains, that's the key word, sustains well over time, long term, because of the enormity of their success, makes a lot of sense to use these two runners as a means to offer us a vision about what proper running form should look like, as they are the upper echelons of human athleticism in running. So it just makes sense to learn from this type of caliber of a runner, in my opinion. Both runners, Bekele and Haley G, have many common mechanical traits. One is a pronounced forward lean from the ankles, especially Bekele, which has been said to give these runners a little more economic strength because the collision slash break force gets phased out by leaning forward from the ankles. And it may also create new parameters that allows for a faster running pace to be sustained with greater ease. Now, I posted the reference links to those findings in the description box down below the video. Overall, if you really look into the research yourself, you'll find that if you want mechanics that works for good running economy, you may want to consider leaning forward, not from the hips, but from the ankles. And just by watching a lot of running form analysis around the web, it really seems that most, not all, but most East African runners run in line in terms of upper body posture with how pose running advises. I just wanted to clarify why it may be okay to lean forward, but from the ankles, not from the hips during running. And of course, in all areas of research, there are competing theories, but it's the buildup of all those theories that gives us all the more important details that can really turn things around and create new opportunities for us to learn to run better. Now, by no means am I suggesting that pose running is fundamentally right and Dr. Lieberman is fundamentally wrong with respects to proper upper body posture in running. I just wish that Dr. Daniel Lieberman went into a little more detail about the functional relevance and mechanical advantages of running upright or being vertical from the hips up to give his claim more convincing weight. So I'll have to find his line of evidence on that and report it to you. But the bottom line is that there's always going to be a basic contrast and a cross-section of perspectives from the experts. Both bodies of work are very iconic in the running community. And overall, the more we learn from experts on natural running, the more it can really turn things around in helping runners help themselves in creating new opportunities to learn to run better and more enjoyably. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button and be sure to click the subscribe button down below to get updated on all the latest research on the hot button debate, heel strike running versus forefoot strike running, as well as shod or shoe running versus barefoot minimalist running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.